स्टूडेंट्स हाउ आर यू होप यू आर डूइंग गुड आदर्श विद्यालय मेट्रिकुलेशन हायर सेकेंडरी स्कूल वेलकम्स यू फॉर ऑनलाइन क्लास यस वी विल कंटिन्यू विथ अवर चैप्टर 4 माइक्रोसॉफ्ट वर्ड 2007 एंड दिस इज अवर सेशन 2 यस इन दिस सेशन वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस हाउ टू मिनिमाइज एंड मैक्सिमाइज द रिबन To display and hide the ruler, to create new blank document, working with the text will have quick recall and have today's review questions, right? Yes, we'll start with the first topic, how to minimize and maximize the ribbon. Ready to listen? How to minimize and maximize the ribbon? Right, here it comes. Hey students, now we are going to see how to minimize and maximize the ribbon menu. Before that, look at here. This is your office button. Can you see? This is your office button. And this is these icons are, can you see with zero mark? So this is your quick access toolbar. Can you find it? Quick access toolbar. And below that from home till down up to this. Yes, it is called as a ribbon menu. Can you see? This is ribbon menu. Whenever I click one tab, there comes different options for you to work with the word. So this is called as a ribbon menu. Now we are going to see how we are going to minimize and maximize the ribbon menu. Just give a right click anywhere on this ribbon menu. Can you find the minimize the ribbon option? Minimize the ribbon. Yes, select that option. Can you see now the ribbon menu is minimized? Right. Again give a right click. See, the checkbox is given. Yes, it is there tick option. Right. Again click, the ribbon menu will appear. This is how we maximize and minimize the ribbon menu. Are you clear? So give a right click. Click minimize the ribbon. Right. Next. Again give a right click. Again set the same option. The ribbon menu will minimize and maximize. Yes. Hope you are clear with how to minimize and maximize. Let us see. Right click anywhere in the main menu. Select the minimize the ribbon option in the menu appears. So you can click again and again. To toggle the ribbon on and off. I think you're very clear how to minimize and maximize the ribbon. Next, how to display and hide the ruler. Ready? Yes. Here it goes. Next, we are going to see how to display and hide the ruler. How to display and hide the ruler. Can you see here? This is the horizontal ruler. And can you see here? The same here. This is your vertical ruler, right? So this is used to adjust your margins. Okay, for was used, it is used to adjust your margins. See here, see at above this right side scroll bar. Can you see the scroll bar above that? Can you find that button called as view ruler button? So when you click this button, give a left click on this button, the ruler will be hidden. Can you see? Now you can't see that ruler from the left and right. Can you see? Right. Next, again, if you select the same option, the ruler will appear. Can you find the difference? So this is how it toggle on and off. How the switch is there to on and off. Same way, this button is here to toggle on and off. What do you mean toggle? Just a change of state from one option to another. So that is called as a toggle. So this is how the ruler can be displayed and hidden using this view ruler button. Can you see? It's moving, it's display, it's getting hidden, right? Right, now you're clear with the ruler button, isn't it? So you can click the view ruler icon over the scroll bar. This view ruler icon also like a toggle button to turn ruler on and off. Clear, students? Next comes how to create a new blank document. This topic we have seen in the previous session also, and I'm continuing with the detail view, right? So ready to listen? Next we are going to see how we are going to create a new Word document. Yes, for this first we have to select the Microsoft Office button. In that, can you find the new option here? It is highlighted in yellow color. Can you see? So click that new button. Yes, a submenu will appear. In this, can you see? It is selected as blank document. Yes. Next, can you see it down? See the cursor how it moves, right? Can you find this create button? Yes, click create. Now a new document is created. Can you see at the top? Microsoft Word. Right. So this is how we create a new document. Click Office button, click New, yes, select blank document and then give create. Clear? I hope now you are very clear how to create a new blank document. So you have to click the Microsoft Office button, in that select New, the new document dialog box appears, in that select blank document. Now click create, a new blank document appears. Isn't it, students? Do you understand? Next is the working with the text. We'll see in detail how to work with the text. Yes. Next, we are going to discuss about working with the text. Under working with the text, these are the five things we are going to discuss. Insert, delete, select, copy, paste, drag and drop. Insert, delete, select, copy, paste, drag and drop. How to insert a text in a word? See, I have typed few things in the word. How I have inserted text inside a word? Listen, can you see a black thing is blinking here and there? Wherever I keep that mouse and if I click there, the black color point is coming, black color vertical line. So this line is called as the insertion point. So this line, the blinking line, is called as the insertion point. So keep your mouse where, keep this insertion point where you want the text to appear. For example, see, I want to type the text here. Just I'm keeping the mouse there. And I am typing the text. So how to insert a text? Place the insertion point where you want to place the text. Then start typing, the text will appear on the screen. Clear? Next, how to delete a text? For example, in delete we have two options. One is we can delete the text before insertion point and delete the text after insertion point. So what are the option to delete a text? One is before insertion point, another one is after insertion point. So for example, so to delete, see, I'm going to delete this B. In backspace, I'm going to delete this B. So keep your insertion point. Yes. You can use backspace to delete the left of the insertion point. And you can use delete key to delete the character after the insertion point. Clear? So left of the insertion point, if you want to delete, you can use backspace. If you have to remove the character after the insertion point, you have to use the delete key. Clear? With the backspace and delete, right? Next, how to select a text? How to select a text? For example, keep your mouse pointer where you want to select. Just give left click in your mouse and hold it, yes, and drag it down. Can you see how the text is selected? It is highlighted one. It is highlighted. Can you see in blue color? Sky blue color, it is highlighted. So this is how we select a text. Next, how to copy a text? For example, I want to copy, insert a word, okay mom, I want to copy it, right? Just copy it. Can you see it is highlighted when you select it, right? And give a right click on that highlighted one. Keep your mouse on the highlighted one and give a right click. Can you find the second option called as copy? Right, select, give left click and select copy. Right, for example, I want to place this text here, select near, right? And keep your insertion point near the select. And again, give a right click on that. Can you find the option called, third option called as paste? Yes. Give a paste. Can you see? Now it is copy and pasted. Right. Same way, you can again select it. And you can give a shortcut key in the keyboard called Control C. You have to simultaneously, you have to first hold the Control key and additionally hold the C key. Right, now give Control C. Right, now again place it here and give it Control V to paste. So shortcut key for copy is Control C and shortcut key for paste is Control V. Clear for you? Copy and paste. So shortcut key for copy is Control C and for copying and how to paste it is Control plus V. Clear? Right. Next, drag and drop. How to drag and drop? Yes. First, for example, you select the text. Yes. And hold it and move it here. Can you see how it is dragged and dropped? It is done with the mouse, right? Yes. Just select the text, right? And hold the text and bring it down where you want to place it. Then you can release your mouse. Then your content will be pasted in that location. Can you see? See, for example, select it, then bring it down. Can you see? So this is how we drag and drop a text. I hope you're clear with all the working with the text, how to insert a text, how to delete a text, select text and copy and paste the text. Drag and drop the text. Clear, students? We'll have a quick recall what we have seen in the today's session class. Right? How to minimize and maximize the ribbon, how to display an hide ruler, how to create a new blank document working with the text. Right? Next, we'll see the few questions. So here comes the first three of fill in the blanks and next four are the question answers. Just go through the video again and again to find the answer for the questions. I hope you'll be very clear with the question answers. Right? Hey students, it's time to say bye-bye. Thank you.